Another day of Sparta, baby. Another day. I got my gender reveal this weekend, so I'm leaving Thursday. What do you think it is? I like that you're wearing blue though today.
You really want to know what I think?
Yeah, tell me what you think, baby. I wouldn't mind. Spoil it, you know.
Her.
Spoil her. My V. I've been in the it phase because I don't want to make it, you know. So. Yeah, if it's a girl, I'll spoil her. You know, 16 years old, buy her a Porsche or something. You know, pay for her college. Hopefully she's like sports, but if she doesn't, fuck it. Maybe she'll be a singer or something.
She can wrestle?
No, my girlfriend's not gonna let her, man. I've already talked to her about it. I don't think it's gonna happen. Yeah, I don't know if it's gonna happen though, man. My girlfriend seems pretty, stuck on the fact that she's not going to. She says she can play some sports, so maybe we'll dabble in soccer, maybe softball or something.
So what's the plan of attack for today? What are you doing?
I'm sparring Ed Ruth. Two or three rounds. Probably three today. Our rounds are really hard, though, so we'll see. It's a very high-level battle. We have very similar stuff, but he has a little bit more reach on me, so it makes things a little bit of a difference. But it's good. It's good for me, man. I'm good for him. He's good for me. We're both trying to be the best in the world, and you become the best in the world by competing against the best in the world. So we'll continue to make our mark, continue to get better, and represent our families and AKA as much as we can. So,
what's your next fight?
It's November 8th. Bellator debut, Thackerville, Oklahoma. Should be a good one, man. Just looking for the opponent. Might even get on the Ariel Helwani show this week sometime. That's pretty big. So we'll see.
You're getting inside, really. Hit some up with that, okay?
Must be so much fun. Do you ever wear cups when you were sparring, Bob?
No.
Never? You're the one that taught these guys because I always wore a cup.
Okay. What time?
2 minutes. Very nice. Thirty seconds.
All the way out, don't stay there. Turn your face off. Turn your face. Don't stay there. Can't take damage there.
Time! That's it, you guys. Good job.
As you were saying, on that angle, the high kick landed on his chin. That's got to throw off it. Yeah, I feel it. That's because he's tall.
It takes time to get that.
And he's tall.
I suffered from that a lot. It's just a lot of times as you start crunching, it's like you kind of work your way up.
Because I feel like he's getting taller.
And then you end up
That was the best one yet, though, right?
Yeah, your knees are pretty good. I said Friday might be the best. Your knees are pretty good.
Oh, no. Well, that was better because I had a good first round.
I just don't think anyone's going to be fighting like that.
You better hope not.
Well, I mean, I really won't mind.
No way in hell nobody will be fighting like that.
No. Just all kinds of shit. No matter where I'm at, I feel like I'm in punching range.
You take five steps, turn around, you're still in range.
And he's throwing a kick, and the motherfucker like goes like this.
Right by
I was
head.
Like, oh my, where the fuck do I go?
Did he catch you a little over in the corner with that one? That one looked like it landed at the high, yeah.
No. He hit me the one.
The hands were a little low.
He hit me right on the like the thumb area.
Yeah.
But the one he did get me with an uppercut over here. I bent down to fake my shot, and that motherfucker went bang. Oh, on the bay, get in.
How was it working with Tomas?
That dude's an animal, legend.
What benefits do you think it brings to you?
Everything, especially when it comes to my kicks. Punches, speed, power, he got it all. So he's one of the greatest in here. I love him.
You feel good that he kind of took you under his wing now?
Oh, yeah. Since I've been here, I've learned a lot. You know, it's a bunch of high-level guys in here. And everybody in here working hard, trying to be the next best person that they were the other day. And the atmosphere is great. Best gym out here. Come check it out.
¿Qué crees de la pelea de México? Comentario.
¿En total o de una pelea en sí?
En total.
Yo creo que la afición mexicana más que nada fue el protagonista de la noche. Porque no se le puede mentir a la afición mexicana, no se le puede mentir, no se le puede dar un show. Si ya pagaron por algo, tiene que haber short, tienen que ver algo. Entonces yo creo que ese fue el final de... por lo que pasó de que empezaron a aventar cosas, aventar vasos. Yo creo que eso fue que la afición es demasiado intensa, lleva muchos sentimientos al cuando va hacia el evento. Ya es personal, ya tiene una idea de a quién va a ir a apoyar, ya tiene una idea de lo que va a ir a hacer, ya es personal. Entonces yo creo que creyeron que estaba mintiendo el peleador de lo de la picada del ojo. Y como todos quieren soltar algo, estaban listos a gritar, hasta a gritar cuando empezara la pelea, y yo creo que eso fue el resultado. Y las peleas pasadas, Brandon, yo creo que Brandon ganó esa pelea, igual que Alexa Grasso ganó también esa pelea, pero los mexicanos se vieron muy bien, el nivel de México está subiendo demasiado bien. Está subiendo va muy, muy, muy rápido para arriba, y creo que finalmente se está viendo que puede haber un campeón mundial mexicano en esa división, en la división de 145 o en la división de las mujeres. Alexa Grasso, el nivel mejoró mucho. Al último le faltó poquito para terminar la pelea, pero fue más por el rival que no quiso tapear, pero esa llave estaba dentro. Muy buen, la verdad, me gustó bastante, y soy un fan más de todos ellos, y la verdad voy a seguir siendo, y creo que puede haber un buen futuro.
¿Y tú crees que el UFC sí va a regresar a México?
Según he escuchado que regresaban en dentro de 6 meses otra vez, a mediados del próximo año, perdón. Pero por lo que pasó, no sé si vayan a regresar.
¿Te gustaría pelear en una carta de UFC en México?
Ah, me encantaría pelear, porque pues siempre el sueño de todo peleador desde el principio, desde que empiezan, lo primero que conocen, la primera promotora es la UFC. Entonces, sí, siempre fue como que, bueno, pues, o sea, me encantaría pelear ahí, si estoy en otra compañía, que es Combate Américas, que me han dado demasiado respeto y confianza. Y me encanta esa, pero si algún día se da que llego a la UFC, encantado.
Y para aclarar algo, cuando los fans gritan puto,
sí,
no es para decir algo.
No es homosexual. No es homosexual, es simplemente sacando esa intensidad que traen, yo creo que es más como apoyando al peleador que van a ir a ver, ¿no? Tanto como en soccer como en peleas, ¿no? No es ofendiendo a nadie, es simplemente la intensidad del momento que es lo que sacas eso.
Es que la gente no entiende que es.
No entiende.
La costumbre diferente.
Lo ven como si fueran homofóbicos, pero las palabras, el significado de las palabras son muy diferentes.
Verdad, no es igual.
No es igual, el significado
para
es muy
aclarar,
diferente.
Porque todos creen que es algo vulgar.
Sí, que es vulgar y que están ofendiendo a alguien, pero es nada más es la palabra que se dio para sacar la intensidad y el apoyo hacia el otro, hacia el peleador.
Yeah. So it is what it is.
But you lost?
We lost.
Yeah, we lost.
Who beat you? Svitkov beat Burroughs.
Burroughs?
Yeah, but he beat him last year in the world. He beat him twice. Yeah, he's beat him in the last like 5 seconds both times.
Both times? So he's got his number in the last five seconds?
The last 5 seconds. But the Olympic gear is a big gear, but man, Burroughs keeps getting a little older and older. So.
Older and older?
Yeah. He's young and he's good.
He's from San Rafael.
But he beat Chamizo, which is the Italian guy who's just like Burroughs.
And so he beat him too?
He beat them both back to back. So the dude's the real deal, man. Very good. So they had a good. Russia's just good. Wow.
Habib donated the money to the gym.
Really?
So DC has to pay the gym.
Yeah, the gym.
Habib said so.
Habib. We were talking to Habib yesterday, and he told us.
He owed me some Gucci shoes, so I'll take the Gucci shoes out of there and he can give you the rest.
Gucci shoes?
Yeah. We still have to play basketball.
Yeah,
we still have to play basketball, too.
I got breakfast on that. You guys lose.
You're tripping.
I'm against you guys.
That's that one.
5 minutes.
One day left. No, sure. Last 12, 13 days until the fight.
Nice.
Last hard week, inshallah. Two years now.